Hello friends, welcome to today's video. So today we'll be discussing the general knowledge and current affairs of the month October 2020. You know, starting with the National Institute of Nutrition, which is also known as NIN, which is under the ICMR, which is the Indian Council of Medical Research. So now they have revised the ideal weight for the adult woman. So earlier it was 65 kgs, means it was 60 kgs, but now it is 65 kgs. So this is a key term to remember. Similarly, for females, they have from 50 to 55 kgs. And also they have revised the definition of Indian adult from 20 to 39 years to 19 to 39 years. So the ideal weight is for man is 65 kgs. 65 kgs for man, 55 kgs for woman. And the Indian adult is from 19 to 39 years. So these are the key terms. Next, you know, Boeing, which is a aircraft manufacturer, they have made a custom made aircraft, which is known as the Air India One. This is the key term, which is a type of B777 aircraft. It is a model and it is named as Air India One. So it will be used to fly the president, Vice President and Prime Minister of India. So Boeing has made it specially for Indian VIPs. Vice President, Vice President and Prime Minister of India. Its name is Air India One. You know, recently in the 2020 UN Global Climate Action Award, you know, one of our Indian expedition group, which is a global Himalayan expedition group, they were one among the winners of this. So this you can just remember this. Next, you know, the Hyderabad International Airport, which is a GHIL airport, GMR Hyderabad International Airport, it has been awarded the best airport by size and the region for the best environment and ambience. Best environment ambience in the Asia Pacific region for the this category of passengers. That is 15 to 25 million passengers category. So it has been adjudged the best airport. So this you can remember. Coming to the smart cities, you know, recently UNESCO has announced Vienna as the smartest city award. So last year Vienna got this award. This you can remember. Next, you know, World Space Week is celebrated from October 4th to October 10th, which is announced by the United Nations of General Assembly. So it is celebrated because of the first human-made Earth satellite Sputnik. So this you can remember, this general knowledge term. First human-made Earth satellite. So what they'll be doing is they'll be doing celebrating the space science and technology. And the theme for this last year was the satellites improve life. So this you can just remember. Next, moving to textiles, you know, Union Minister of Textiles, Smriti Irani, has launched the first ever brand and logo. This you can remember. This is the first ever brand and the logo for Indian cotton. So it was launched on October 7th. So this Indian premium cotton will be known as the Kasturi cotton. So and also in this function, they have released a new logo. So this you can remember. Indian brand is Kasturi cotton. Next. You know, in Singapore, now online government service can be availed using the biometric facial recognition. So this is the first of its kind in the world. So they are moving towards the facial recognition, which is a biometric based. Next, recently India on 3rd October, they have successfully tested the Shaurya, which is a surface to surface nuclear capable ballistic missile. So this you can remember, Shaurya is a surface to surface ballistic missile. So now e-invoicing has been promoted with digital to promote the digital India. E-invoicing will be made to tax payers in India who are having a turnover of more than rupees 100 crores. So invoicing will be made so that So this will replace all the physical invoices and it will replace the existing e-way bill system. You know, e-way bill system is something where all the logistics which are having rupees for more than 50,000, they will be compulsory to have a e-way bill system. Now they are slowly moving towards the e-invoicing. So this is a big move towards the logistics handling. So you can just remember e-invoicing is replacing the e-way bill system. So recently, Uttar Pradesh Governor Anandiben Patel has released a book which is a Signtune book. The name of the book was Signtune. So it basically contains information how the COVID-19 pandemic and its symptoms and preventions can be taken through precautions. You can just remember the name Signed Stone Book launched by UP Governor Anandiben Patel. This is not needed. Awkward. Recently, Kerala state in South India has become the first state in the country to set floor prices, the base prices for the 16 varieties of vegetables. So this you can remember. Floor prices for 16 varieties has been set by Kerala government, and this is the first state in the country to do so. In Russia, the opposition leader, who is Mr. Alexei Navalny, you can remember his name. So recently, somebody has tried to poison him. So the European Union has decided to impose a targeted sanctions and who are alleged involved in poisoning that. You just remember that the opposition leader Russian is Alexei Navalny. He's a very famous person. Next, in Goa, Indian government is planning to have a first sand dune park. Sand dunes are very popular for tourists, and there are many motor sport activities that are conducted. So this will promote the tourism also. So first sand dune park they are planning in Goa. Sand dunes are the deposits which are formed by the action of the wind. You can just remember this. Next, recently the Supreme Court of India has appointed a one-man committee. This is a one of its kind, so you can remember this one-man committee where a retired Supreme Court judge, Justice Madan B. Lokar, has been appointed. So this you can remember. So what this committee will do is they will take the steps to prevent the stubble burning in Punjab, Haryana, and UP. Stubble burning is one of the biggest issues near Delhi, where all the stubble is burned, so a lot of climate change is happening. So they have appointed this one-man committee, so he'll be taking some steps. Recently a rocket named New Shepard has been test launched recently by the Blue Origin. So Blue Origin is basically a company founded by the Amazon CEO, who is Mr. Jeff Bezos. So it's kind of a reusable rocket. You can just remember that company name Blue Origin, who is the same CEO who is having the Amazon. So CEO Jeff Bezos. Next, Ebola is also one such important disease which was affected in the last 2 years. So United States regulatory body, which is the FDA, which is also a Food and Drug Administration, they have now approved the first drug for the treatment of Ebola, and the drug name is Enmazeb, Inmazeb. So this you can remember. Ebola treatment is drug name is Enmazeb. Next, near Delhi, the quality of air quality is very, it is deteriorating day by day. So now the Indian Meteorological Department, IMD, they have operationalized a new warning system, which is Advanced High Resolution Air Quality System. That name is Enfuser, which is Environmental Information Fusion Service. So it's a kind of a warning system. So that will tell the government regarding the air quality. So you can just remember. You also know that in IMD is the department which provides the meteorological services to aviation in India. All the meta and specie are issued by IMDs. Next, recently a report was released by the US-based State of Global Air. So what they did, as per the report, India recorded the highest average PM2.5 concentration exposure in the world last year. So this is not good. So it's a pollution index, and India has been not been performing good in this category. You can just remember this. So India recorded the highest annual average PM2.5 concentration exposure. This is the key term. Next. Now, recently in North Korea, they have announced they have urged the citizens to avoid the contact with a mysterious cloud of yellow dust. Some yellow dust was seen that time, and then the government there has announced that the yellow dust is actually blowing in from the China that could actually bring the SARS-CoV with it. So it is a virus of COVID-19. So you can just remember that yellow dust what came in Korea, and they have alerted that it could contain the COVID-19 virus. Next. LTC is something, a leave travel concession. So normally government employees, they are given the LTC option, so that wherein they can avail tax benefits. But now the government of India has extended this income tax exemption scheme to non-central government employees, including the state government, public sector, and banks and the private sector. So this you can remember. LTC once in 2 years, normally an employee is availing this one by the central government, but now they have extended to non-central government employees and bank and private sectors also. Moving to Oscars, last year Oscar 2020, some of the important things to remember are the best picture was won by the movie named Parasite. It is a Korean movie, so it has won the best picture. And the same movie director has got the award. His name is Bong Joon-ho. So he got for the same movie Parasite. And then the best actor was went to Joaquin Phoenix for the movie Joker. Then coming to the best female actress, it went to Renee Zellweger for the movie Judy. And the best screenplay also went to the movie Parasite. So these you can remember. Best picture, director, actor, and actresses, and screenplay. For this year, Oscar 2021 is going to be held on 26th of April 2021. So if at all anything related to Oscar will come, it will be based on 2020. So you can remember these five. I think these would be sufficient. So these were the important current affairs for the October 2020 and some of the general knowledge. If you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos. Thank you for watching.